Get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brent Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Sarah Purcell, Richard Dawson. From the Betty White Show, Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers!
Thank you, John. How are you?
Thank you, Brandy.
What?
Aren't they in the wrong
place? Yes, yes.
Did you know the deceased well?
Yes, I knew her very well. Now, these are one of our contestants who was on the show not too long ago, Marcy Schneidmiller, wanted all of you to know how much she appreciated your kindnesses and your matches and all that. And I thought that was nice of her. Maybe we can just leave him on the set here and decorate our set a little bit, or cover Brett's face like that.
It's very nice. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Marcy. That was very sweet of you.
From her hair, she took a rose and tossed it to me there.
What's that?
I said, from her hair, she took a rose and tossed it to me there. I, in my turn, kissed the rose and tossed her back her hair.
Right. He said, what's that?
That's a little while.
I want you to meet an old beau of mine.
Thank you, Betty.
Listen, we got a new kid on the block. We've never had Sarah Purcell with us before. And in accordance...
Maybe I should borrow some of that, too.
Why?
Here, let
me... Why, have you been kissing someone else? Oh, that. Oh, I see. Would you briskly applause a new kid on the block, Sarah Purcell?
Oh, yeah.
Welcome.
Thank you very much.
Sarah has her own show now.
Boy, she's excellent.
Yes, and you're very good.
Thank you very much. I share, you know, with
you're with
Bill
what's his name? Yeah, right.
What is his name?
Why, Bill Anderson.
Oh, sure.
They're both very good on it together. They make a wonderful couple.
It's a mystery show, of course. Yes. You'll notice we've not mentioned the name, The Better Sex.
Right,
thank you,
there
Richard.
It is. All right, that's one.
It's so peppy. I work on that other network. We all work here, and they all say, don't mention the other place, you know.
Don't say Family Feud.
I won't say.
No, you can't say Family Feud. Now, stop that.
I didn't say it.
CBS is going to have a hip. They're going to have a heart attack.
Well, we won't mention the network.
All right.
We will not.
Okay, don't mention the network.
See, to find out.
Say hello to our two players here, Susie Mallett and Joan Ellison. Where are we? Oh, I see. Susie is the current champ. She's won two games. You have $300, right?
That's right.
Okay, how you feel today, Susie?
I feel great.
Good. And now, Joan, how you doing?
I'm doing just beautifully.
You have a question coming up, right?
I think so.
Right away, we're going to start with the second and final round of your game. At this moment, the score is 1-0 in favor of Joan. We'll see how this game ends right after we see about this. Here we go. Second and final round. Joan, it's up to you to make a decision now. You may have A or B.
Well, I chose B last time. I think I'll stay with it.
You want B?
Yes, sir.
You got it. All right. One person does not play. That is Richard. The other, please respond to this. Ethel said, I don't think my husband loves me anymore because as my last birthday present, he gave me a blank for my neck. Takes a little while to catch on to it. How's good old Charles?
Fine. How are you?
Very well.
What does it say?
Ethel said, I don't think my husband loves me anymore because for my last birthday present, he gave me a blank for my neck.
Do you know who loves us?
Who loves us?
Vermont.
We love Vermont.
I went to Vermont and everybody said, oh, I love your show. Except for you, Noah.
Oh, except, oh, I see.
No, they just, and they were so...
Hello, Joan.
Hello, Joan.
Here it is. Ethel said, I don't think my husband loves me anymore because as my last birthday present, he gave me a blank for my neck.
Collar and leash.
Collar and leash. Yeah. Collar and leash. It's not bad. I think it's a rather imaginative answer if you want to know the truth. Isn't it, Nipsey?
Well, that's a kind of a put-down, but I mean, he really didn't love her because he gave her a hangman's noose.
A hangman's noose. That's getting right to it, isn't it? What do you say?
Well, I sort of did that. I said a rope with a... Wait a week. With a hangman's knot.
Okay, that's not a dog collar and leash.
Oh, all right.
Did you say dog collar and leash by any chance?
No, I'm sorry. I said what the others said.
A noose.
Because he got it.
Leave him alone.
On one card only, it was necessary.
Well, there is a paper shortage, isn't there? I don't think my husband loves me anymore because of my last birthday present, he gave me a collar and leash.
I'm going to say that.
For my neck.
I've said noose.
Noose. Noose seems to be the popular favorite, Joan.
Does seem to be.
Now, here's Betty White's answer.
Dog lover that I am, I didn't do it.
You didn't.
Said rope.
Rope. R-O-P-E, rope. Okay, so now, Susie, all you have to do is match one to tie and two to win. And here it is. Whoops, come back here. Wouldn't it be great if you could do it? And it would come right back up to you.
If you did it on film instead of tape, you could do that.
All right. Whoops. Ruth said to the psychiatrist.
Ruth?
Ruth.
Right.
Said to the psychiatrist, for years, I told my husband he was a pussycat. Now I'm worried. Yesterday, he started blanking.
For years,
I told my husband he was a pussycat. Now I'm worried. Yesterday, he started blanking.
There are a couple of good answers for that.
Right. Okay, here we go, Susie Mallet. One to tie, two to win. Ruth said to the psychiatrist, for years, I told my husband he was a pussycat. Now I'm worried. Yesterday he started blanking.
Meowing.
Meowing. Okay, one meow to win, one meow to tie, and two to win. Nipsey?
I'm vibrating on a wrong wavelength.
Really?
I said, yeah, he started chasing mice.
Chasing mice. That's a good response. Cats do that, don't they?
Yes, am I glad I didn't get a chance to change my answer.
What'd you say?
Well, I said meowing, but what I had was using a kitty litter box, but I didn't get a chance to put it in, so it
Oh, there's one for her. Tie score. One more
meow
will win the game.
Let's hold up for some suspense, Gene, as we build.
Meow.
There it is. That's the game. What the rest of you have? There you are, there's your regular spot. Joan Ellison, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here, and we'll send some gifts along your way. Joan Ellison, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. While we're spinning it off, let's spin a message or two just for you. Where are we? Well, here we are. Now, Susie's up here for the third time. She ought to get the hang of it by now and win some big money, right?
Right.
You ready for it?
Certainly.
Here we go, Susie. Not too long ago, we polled a studio audience right in this very room, probably. We said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank deposit. Now, the answer they gave us most often, Susie, will get you a total of $500 if you match it. Now, if you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. And three of our six dinglings will give you some assistance here.
Richard.
Safe.
Safe deposit is a good answer.
Brett.
All right.
I have two. Should I go with that or... I like that one better, don't you?
I guess so.
Here we go.
Just watch it.
Speak out.
Bank deposit.
Okay, you got two good ones so far.
And Charles.
Charles. Oh,
I don't care what you say, don't ask me.
No.
N.O. deposit?
Yes, N.O. deposit. What do you want, a song and dance? To keep the pace of the show up. No deposit.
No deposit. What does that mean?
No return.
No deposit, no return.
No, I associate the two of them together.
I'm glad
all right.
I didn't take that one.
I didn't understand it. Thank you for clarifying.
That soft stuff.
Thank you. Right. So you got no deposit, you got no safe deposit, and you got bank deposit. What, you want one of those, or you want to throw them all out and give us one of your own?
I thought of bank deposit.
You thought of bank deposit. That's one that Brett thought of, right? Let's see if we have a bank deposit anywhere on that board. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. No deposit?
No deposit.
Okay, Chuck.
No return.
May we see the $250 number? Safe deposit. You may be right.
I may be wrong, too.
Well, you've been wrong before.
I know.
And you're going to be wrong again.
Oh.
All right, slide it, please. Yeah, you got it. Congratulations.
that. Yeah, good for you, Susie. You got another $500 added to your previous total. You now have $900 altogether. Now you go for the big one. 10 times 500 or $5,000. And remember, we'll give you the money if you'll match one exactly.
I'll go with Richard.
Okay, here we go. Good luck to you, Susie. This is it, worth $5,000. And it reads as follows. Here and blank. That's H-E-R-E and A-N-D, blank. All right, Susie, he's finished. Give us the answer that he's written on the card, and we give you $5,000.
Here and there.
Yay! Here and there. Okay, she says here and there. We'll turn to Richard now and find out if she matches him.
I wish we did. Here and now.
Here and now.
Either or.
That was my other one.
Either or.
Really?
Either or.
Now, did you think of here and now and reject it?
I did. No. Here and there was my first one.
Well, your first one.
Yeah.
All right. That's what we say here. Trust your first instinct, and usually it works, but that time it did not. They were both good responses, and now, Susie, you've got another challenger coming up, so would you all welcome John Clark. You know, Susie, John?
Hi, Susie. How are you?
All right. How's John today?
Just fine, thank you.
Where are you from, John?
I'm from Simi Valley, just out of the smog here from L.A.
You mean it's less smoggy in Simi than in
Los
Angeles?
That's correct.
It is?
Yes, just there's
is
a little mountain
there. Is it north,
there.
South, east, or west of here? Can't be west of
Northwest.
Here. Northwest.
Ventura County.
Oh, yes, of course. What do you do, John?
I'm a chiropractor.
You are?
Mm-hmm. Work on people's backs all day.
Right. You married?
Yes, married, have two children, play a lot of sports.
Really? Like what?
Oh, softball, tennis, golf.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We play a lot of sports here, too, don't we?
Great.
Every chance we get.
Right. They really play around a lot. I mean, they really do. All right, good luck to you, John. You're up first. You can have A or B.
Okay, let's try B, Gene.
B. All right, good luck. Here we go. Ready?
Ready.
Go. Jackie, the comic said, yesterday I gave a special performance for The Godfather. Never again. At the end of my act, instead of giving me a hand, he gave me a blank. Jackie the comic said, yesterday, I gave a special performance for The Godfather. Never again. At the end of my act, instead of giving me a hand, he gave me a blank. Jackie the comic said, yesterday, I gave a special performance for The Godfather, and never again. At the end of my act, instead of giving me a hand, he gave me a blank.
He gave me an offer I couldn't refuse.
He gave me an offer I couldn't refuse. It's a very clever answer, John.
What did he say?
I didn't expect you're going to win with it, but it was clever.
We do our best.
He said he gave me an offer I couldn't refuse.
Oh, cute.
It's cute. It's clever.
Yeah. I saw the same movie. He gave me a horse's head in my bed.
A horse's head in my bed. What'd you say?
I didn't say what Charlie couldn't get Charles's answer. He had it so cleverly covered. I said he gave me a hitman.
Gave me a hitman.
You know what a
anything,
hitman
yeah,
is.
Anything connected with
it. Why doesn't an ex-mall tell us exactly what a hitman is?
A fist. Okay. Three different responses so far. And so far, John, yours has not come up. The offer I couldn't refuse. Hello, Sarah.
Hello.
How are you?
Well, I'm fine.
Good.
How about a mwah? Kiss.
Kiss.
Bye.
Il bacio di morto. What do you say?
Ancora.
Ancora. Due baci.
Due baci.
Due baci.
Due baci. You due baci.
E lei? Che dice lei?
I don't care what it means. I just like to hear it. You think he'll get ahead with an answer like that?
Yes, he will.
He will? Because if he does,
There's one. Well, the horse's head came up because, you know, that was in the book and that was in the movie and all that. And, John, that's why they said that.
Okay.
So that's none for you, and yours will be along in a moment. Right now, we got this for you. Terrific. Here we go. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. Oh, wait a minute now.
What'd you do? What'd you do, sweetheart? Do you need help, dear?
It's coming.
Is that the right one?
Yeah.
You want A or B? Oh, okay. Okay. Sorry. The principal said, Miss Grundy says that her new class is too rough. Sure, they gave her an apple, but they took her blank. Principal said, Miss Grundy says that her new class is too rough. Sure, they gave her an apple, but they took her blank.
Put it in the slot, Nipsey. That's right. Oh, you have. All right. There we go. Everybody's ready now. And we come to Susie. The principal said, Miss Grundy says that her new class is too rough. Sure, they gave her an apple, but they took her blank.
Clothes.
Took her clothes, huh?
That's rough.
Yes. And probably very instructive, too. Yes.
I was thinking kind of scholastically. What is a homonym?
A homonym?
Yeah.
It's just... No, that's...
It's similar to a synonym, isn't
yeah.
it?
It's the opposite
of synonym.
I don't
think
synonym.
That's an antonym.
A homonym is a word that sounds like another there. Word and means the same thing.
Yeah, but
no, synonym
means something
mean
different. Thing. See, I tell you.
I'm sorry, I brought it up. He gave why her an you... apple, but they took her pear.
Oh. That is not a homonym.
Oh, it isn't. No.
It is a homonym.
A homonym is an opposite, is it not?
That's an antonym.
No.
Oh, yes, that's the one I want.
That's an antonym.
Okay. I said, no, no, this may be a match, and then again. I said they took her pantyhose.
Oh, that's
they
close.
Left the rest of
no. Okay. All right.
Well, they were planning a rob someplace. They need to pull over.
Oh, I see. Sure. Charles?
Whee! Be a nurse, Gene. I've said this for 3 years. Well, I was working from the apple. They gave her the apple, but she couldn't eat it because they took her false teeth.
Uh-huh. Very rational. Sarah Charles was very rational.
Very
what about
rational.
You?
Very
you rational.
Very rational. I'm one of your more rational people, rationing
really?
All the time. But I said that they took her blackboard.
Took the black, ripped it right off the wall.
Yeah, right off the wall and right out of the little
you
slot,
you are
too.
Steadily employed. You have your own show, don't
yes,
you?
Yes, keep it, right.
Yes. You have two of your own shows, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, well, you're all right. What do you say, Rich?
You're going to need them both, by the way.
I know.
I said teeth.
Teeth. Yeah, that could follow the apple thing there.
What's the score?
The score? We got no score. What do you say?
Once Sarah won the Beautiful Sweater of the Week award, she just has gone downhill from there. That's all. Teeth, I said.
Teeth it is. All right, that seems to be the good response. So there we are at the end of round one. We have no score. Zip to zip. We'll see how round two goes after this. Now, let's see if we got time here to do A or B, John.
Let's try A this time, Gene.
A is A. All right, John, good luck to you. Here we go with A. Fred said, yeah. My wife is so shy.
How shy is she?
I'm going to tell you, she even blanks with her clothes on. She even blanks with her clothes
oh,
on.
I tell you,
that's
my,
how shy she is.
I want you to know, I know so many people like that, I can't begin
put
to
put it down
discuss.
Already. Good, 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 good. All right, while Nipsey is writing, John, I'll read it to you one more time.
I already done rotten.
Fred said, my wife is so shy, she even blanks with her clothes on.
Oh, boy. let's try makes love.
Makes love with her clothes on. He went for it, Nipsey.
What's the old, what do you go for?
Makes love.
She makes love.
Right.
Well, ain't nothing shy about that. That's a
makes
good
love.
Man.
Beautiful. What do you say?
You know when we go to Encino?
Shh.
That's not shy. That's just simple girlish mind.
Uh-huh.
Makes love.
Makes love.
Betty White doesn't know anything about
it. Right. Wrong. Charles?
Well, Fredericks of Hollywood has made a fortune. In their window now, they have a harem number that's just fantastic. Go buy dry. I said bathes and showers. I'm sorry.
Bathes and showers. That was the first thing that came to my mind, and we'll see what came to Sarah Purcell's mind now. What do you say?
First rational, and now clean. So clean that she bathes
when the clothes on. A little soggy when she's finished, right?
El Similario, bathes and showers.
Bathes and or showers. What do you say?
I thought of makes love, but I thought everybody gets there. You know,
really?
I didn't. Yes. So I said bathes.
Uh-huh. Bathes. So that came up a couple times now. And I guess we've got to
stop right now here. We don't have time to do any more. And we look forward to meeting both of you next time when we'll finish this game. Thank you. You were all splendid.
Thank you.
Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for Match Game 77.